In this question, the specific gravity of the stream was a lot closer to that of benzene, so 0.85 compared to 0.879, than it was to hexane, which has a specific gravity of 0.66. All right, and so we expect that the stream is made up mostly of benzene. We could do a calculation converting mass to volume, so kilograms per hour to liters per hour, simply by using the overall density of the stream. And so we expect that the number that we'll have a number that's reasonably close to 800, so more than halfway to 824 liters per hour for the volumetric flow rate of benzene. And so C is the only answer that really meets those criterion. It's not D because it's not all benzene, right? But it's more than half benzene, and so we expect it to be quite a bit higher than 412 liters per hour. So C is the only reasonable answer. But what I wanted to do now is just go through a calculation where we actually show how we calculate this number, 714 liters per hour. So let's write down our given information again. We know that the total mass flow rate is 700 kilograms per hour. We know that the specific gravity of the total stream is 0.850. And we use that information to compute that the total volumetric flow rate of the stream is 824 liters per hour on the previous screen. All right, we have some information also just on the specific gravity of benzene, which is 0.879, and the specific gravity of hexane, which is 0.659. And what we want to know in this problem is the volumetric flow rate of just the benzene. Okay, and to do this, we'll basically add up our components for both a total mass and total volume equation. So let's see how this works. We can say that we know that the two components in our system are benzene and hexane. And so if we add those two mass flow rates, then we expect to get a total mass flow rate of 700 kilograms per hour. But we don't yet know what the individual flow rates, the mass flow rates of the benzene and hexane are. We also know that if we add up the volumetric flow rates for benzene and hexane, that should be equal to the total of 824 liters per hour. All right, but we still have just two equations and four unknowns, which are our two mass flow rates and two volumetric flow rates. And the information that we use in order to eliminate those unknowns are the fact that we have two additional equations here. So we have the specific gravity for benzene and the specific gravity for hexane. And so we can use those, for example, to plug into this equation. So I'll move this down here. All right, and so that mass flow rate is equal to the density of benzene, which is 0.879 kilograms per liter, times the volumetric flow rate of benzene. That gives us the mass flow rate of benzene. And we can multiply the density of hexane, 0.659 kilograms per liter, times the volumetric flow rate of hexane. And that again is equal to 700 kilograms per hour. Okay, and now, so we have two equations now and just two unknowns. All right, I'm gonna do another little trick. There are several ways that we can solve for this, and we can solve for one of these and back substitute. One convenient thing to do is to multiply. We know we wanna solve for the volumetric flow rate of benzene, so we wanna eliminate this volumetric flow rate of hexane. And so what I'll do is I'll just multiply both this equation by 0.659. If we multiply this by 0.659, then 814 times 0.659 is 543. Okay, and so now we can take this equation and that equation and we can subtract one from the other. And what we'll end up with is 0.22 times the volumetric flow rate of benzene is equal to 157. All right, and then we can solve for the volumetric flow rate of benzene, and that should be equal to 157 divided by 0.22 is equal to 714, and that's liters per hour. Okay, and so I was a little bit lazy here, possibly, in carrying forth my units. All right, so these systems have to be dimensionally homogeneous. All right, and so when we multiply this by 0.659, it's actually 0.659 kilograms per liter. And so that makes the dimension of each term in this second equation kilograms per hour, so that we're able to actually do this subtraction. And so let me go ahead and write that in. Okay, and so this is an example where we use we have information on the total mass flow rate and then calculate the total volumetric flow rate of a stream. And we use the individual properties, in this case the specific gravities, of benzene and hexane in order to determine how much the flow rate of each of those components are. So now if we wanted to know the volumetric flow rate of hexane, we could just substitute in now our known volumetric flow rate of benzene into this equation and solve for it.